Who turned on the camera? Is this another Robin Hood movie? No, I'm not making that. No, I don't care. I'm not going to make that video. Gosh, look at what you have done. I've got my audience coming already. Sorry, lads. Sorry, noble ones. But today, no video because, you know, I just don't want to make this video. So thank you for coming. See you next time. Thank you for watching. Okay, that what you want me to make this video? I'll make the video. No. I'll make the video. Just before I can make the video, I need some pasta. So if you'll excuse me. There you go. Lovely jubbly. Okay, now I've got the spiritual strength needed to make this video. Because you see, one of the reasons why I didn't want to make this video is because I get all worked up. Yes, I do, because I really like the Robin Hood story. I think it's a really good story. And that is one of the reasons it really drives me nuts when they have to butcher it like this. Because that's what this film is. It's a butchery. You see, if the best iteration, the best representation of the Robin Hood legend involves foxes, a bear, and a frigging hen, we know that Hollywood has got some problems lately. What do you mean I'm a racist? I've got nothing against foxes, mate. Do what? Your cousin is a fox? Nobody cares, mate. No, do you care that his cousin is... You see, nobody cares, mate. Nobody's standing out for you. You're not part of the show. Just stop. I don't even want to know how that is possible anyways. Just stop it. He doesn't need fires. You see, Robin Hood is such a great tale. It has a lot of potential. And we have seen this. I mean, we have had many, many films trying to do this for us. But yes, Disney one is the best one. Hands down. The costumes are so wrong, and I know what you're gonna say. I know what you're gonna say. You're gonna say, hey Metatron, but did you not realize that it was done on purpose? I suppose it's done on purpose. People look like they're wearing modern clothing, which looks awful, and that is why I'm complaining. It's not like that I don't understand that for whatever artistic reason they chose to do this deliberately. I just don't understand why. Why would you do that? If the film is set in the Middle Ages, it removes all immersion. I mean, look at him. He's literally wearing a t-shirt under a modern plate carrier. Resident Evil 2. I think first and foremost, in order to make a good movie out of the Robin Hood tale, then you have got to first off set it properly. And when I say properly, I mean with proper medieval clothing, nice and colourful, not dirty. You know, getting rid of all the myths that we know that are there, out there, and a lot of people now give for granted. And they think that medieval people were just gloomy and, you know, dirty, everything was brown, everything was covered in mud, and I'm gonna say absolutely not. We know for a fact that medieval people loved colors, they loved life, they were human beings, they bathed. Now, if you've seen already my movies historical evaluations before, like the one on the Outlaw King or many other films, including Roman ones, you know that I do get rather angry when I don't see male armor or chain mail, like many people call it. Because mail, in majority of cases, was one of the most popular and most used kinds of armor in the history of mankind. And yet, in these movies, for whatever reason, the Hollywood production system, apart from the Outlaw King, get rid of mail altogether, replacing it with biker gear. But this movie, this is... This film, mail is on a carriage. On a carriage? Put it on your soldiers, mate! So So I think that to make the best Robin Hood possible, we would have to set it properly with a good setting, you know, talking to actual experts. Regardless of the fact that this film is set in the Middle Ages and during the Crusade era, for whatever reason we've got riot police taking care of what? A bunch of strikers? Oh, that is such an awful representation of the Crusade. Not just because it's not historically accurate, because again, people are going to tell me it's done on purpose. Okay, but I'm talking from an artistic point of view. It's awful, completely out of place. It looks like they are what? Some Navy SEALs, what? American US Marines in Iraq, you know, seeing some real Holy Land Crusade combat with real Crusaders and stuff. It would have been so... Even the way they move, it's basically you just replace the bows with a machine gun, boom, and now you've got the completely different movie. Because that's what it is. It's a completely different movie. This has nothing to do with Robin Hood. Now, you know that normally in films I already complain about the fact that how bows are represented, the idea of, you know, these very clearly weak bows, because people can just draw them without any problem and they keep them drawn, which clearly means that they are very, very weak in terms of poundage. These bows, for whatever reason, they penetrate any kind of possible conceivable armor, which makes absolutely no sense. In order to be a medieval bowman, you needed to be strong, you needed to be trained for many years since youth, because those real medieval war bows, something similar to the Mary Rose bows, they had a lot of draw weight, and we know the medieval archers drew them all the way back to the year, and that is what you need to even conceive the idea of penetrating mail, never mind plate. But in this film, crossbows are like unbelievable. Machine gun crossbows are machine guns, that they're even stationary, like, you know, the turrets in action movies. I normally try to find good in bad movies. Like, I try to, you know, whenever I say a whole lot of bad things about a movie, I also try to find positive things to say, because I think it's only fair. But this time, you know, they're really giving me a hard time. I just can't find anything good about this film. Any other film about Robin Hood was good, was better. In fact, I'm going to say that now it's going to be really tough to do medieval movie reviews or Roman movie reviews, because anything compared to this is going to be an excellent star of the movie universe. On a different note, I've got some Warhammer fantasy, so old Hammer miniatures. One of the things I do, I collect these miniatures and I paint them. I have a question for you. Would you be interested in seeing me paint these miniatures? Well, let me know in the comments below. I've got an interesting poll on my Patreon page. You will find a link in the description below. Anyone can access this poll, so you can as well. And it's a poll that will help me decide what sort of special Patreon content to make from now on. I do make extra videos on Patreon, so if you're interested, this is your chance to literally influence the sort of content that I will be making there. So if you do wish to support me, $1 a month, and you can get access to all of that. Alright, noble ones, but I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, please remember thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content from the Metatron. I hope to see you for my next upload. And if you're not yet a member of this community, become a noble one. Subscribe to my channel for more content from the Metatron. And remember, the Metatron has spread his wings. Goodbye.